Okay, Dick, would you like to take the stage and help us through adopting a new revised, edited, updated policies and procedure manual? About 2 years ago, I guess, we adopted, I think probably the first policy and procedures manual for the commission. The intent then, as it is today, is to make available for everybody, including us, how we intend to conduct ourselves. That sounds pretty simple, but if you consider it in the context of the fact that we are probably the most unique entity there is on the face of the earth, namely a compact approved organization, we're not a state agency. We have no relationship really to the laws of either state in terms of defining how we actually perform. So whatever we do, it seems to me we're trying to capture the spirit of those laws, but we cannot, because they're different, adopt them and say, yeah, that's what we'll do. So Dick has spent, I hesitate to say, but I think probably thousands of hours doing the original and now doing the update. So first let me say thank you very, very much. I think as transparency becomes the buzzword in government and as accountability becomes the buzzword, this document will increase in its value to us, because we are announcing to the world, including the legislatures, here's how we do our business. And if you want to know how to do it, it's on our website and will be posted once we adopt the update, assuming that's what happens today. Dick?
Thank you, Dan. And in fact, when this subject first came up several years ago, I leaped at the opportunity to see if we couldn't codify and put in print for the public to see, and legislators and everybody else that's involved in the rail, just why we are different, and as opposed to trying to explain it extemporaneously. And it's turned into quite a large manual, but it's stood the test of time. Some time has passed since we last updated it, and several significant changes have occurred that we really needed to capture in a newer document. And so what's before the commission today is what's known as version 4 of the policies and practices manual for the commission. And what it reflects is a change that's been going on for the past year and a half or so of the commission trying to evolve into a more unified management structure. And the key thing that happened in that regard was the formation of the Cumbres and Toltec Operating Limited Liability Corporation, which is a wholly owned subsidiary of the commission. And it was formed, as many of you already know, to operate the railroad, and it also led to a more unified management structure, so that where there were separate roles for the executive director in the past and there was a separate operator in the past, those things have been coalesced together. And so what's in this manual now reflects that change and also tries to capture what are the actual practices that have been evolving. There's also some other housekeeping changes that needed to be done just to make sure we were keeping up to date with various other changes. So we've tried to capture all those. And a very important aspect of the manual is that it emphasizes that policy matters remain with the commission and operating matters are now relegated to CTO, with John Bush as the president acting as the general manager of CTO. So all that's captured in this new manual, and it's had quite a bit of opportunity for review by the commission informally, individually over the last couple of months as we've added and changed and amended. So it's before the commission today for adoption, and with that, I turn it back to you, Dan.
Okay, thank you. The one thing I would say is this document being always very fluid because they're changing situations all the time. We very recently, like last week, changed it again, although it's not reflected in the draft. We have included in the manual the open meeting policy that we follow all the time. Basically, it says we make decisions in open meetings. We don't make decisions when we're not in an open meeting. It defines when we are covered by open meetings versus when we're simply attending a social event or something like that. There being four of us, a little hard not to have a quorum, or at least the official limit of two of us together at the same time, and that makes it difficult to operate. One of the things that we are required to have in the open meeting is advance notice. Today, our standard is 10 days out, we notice the meeting, we say that we're going to have the meeting, where it's going to occur, and so forth, inviting the public to attend. Included in that statement is, or notice, is a tentative agenda. The laws of New Mexico have changed, and so we need to amend what we are now amending by adding the requirement for us to have the agenda finalized 72 hours before the meeting, as opposed to our current manual, which says 24 hours. So with that, I would like someone to move that we accept the manual as amended to 72 hours in the open meeting clause, so that we can adopt it and publish it and move on.
I move for approval of the manual as amended to the 72-hour notice.
Thank you. Thank you, Billy.
No discussion?
Yes.
I had one question. Under the section of historic preservation and SHPO oversight, it doesn't discuss the historic preservation fund. And I would request that we go ahead and approve this today, but that we ask Dick to try to get our arms around it, and we capture something about the historic preservation fund.
Excellent suggestion.
Making it and defining it as the responsibility of the commission,
I think it's
to manage, and
it's buried in there already.
Well, maybe you help me find out where it is.
Yeah. Before we leave today,
because
we did add a mention of that, but it's you got a 128-page document.
No, it's 61. It's 61 pages.
With the appendices.
You're right, it's down to 61 pages now.
Yeah, including the appendices.
Yeah.
But do you know where that is? Oh, here it is on page 17. Great, it's in there. So that's the end of my discussion.
Okay. Is there any?
Okay.
It felt like 121 pages.
Yeah.
I don't know where I got that from. If you like, did you want me to read the resolution that we had prepared?
No, I don't think we need to.
Oh, okay.
I already made my motion.
All right.
Just so amend. But the reason for suggesting the resolution, at least for the purposes of the minutes, is so that we make it completely unambiguous as to how the action's being taken, in respect to the provisions of the 1977 amended agreement.
I will change my motion to, on January 24th, 2015, I move that we adopt a revised policies and procedures manual containing changes made in accordance with the commission's powers as encumbered by Part B and with its, amending authority as specified in Part C of the July 1977 amendment to the July 1970 agreement between the states of Colorado and New Mexico under the Cumberson Toltec Scenic Railroad Interstate Compact. That's my motion.
Okay. Thank you.
Who seconded it before?
Billy.
Did you accept that as a change of my
motion?
Yes,
second.
Okay. Any further discussion? All of those in favor, and I want a roll call, please.
Commissioner Love?
Yes.
Commissioner Randall?
Yes.
Commissioner Foster?
Aye.
Commissioner Love?
Yes.
It is unanimous, and please reflect that in the minutes. Thank you all very much.
Mm-hmm.
Thank you, Dick.
Thank you.
Yeah, thanks, Dick.
Once again,
great job.
Till next time.
Huge effort.
Don't go too far away, Dick.
Dick.
Don't go too far away.
Why?
Because I'll be calling on you a little later.
Okay.
I don't need to quote him at the moment, but if you walk all the way back, you're going to have to.
I'll have a coffee spasm, I know.
Okay.
Okay. And your purpose is?
When we get to the visitor center.
You want to just do visitor center now?
All right.
It's up to our chair.
Why don't we flip the agenda then and do that right now so Dick can get back to his chair?
Okay.